Hey guys, it is your boy High Alone and Amir to discuss MVNOs today. Now, a lot of you may be familiar with MVNOs as far as the old school ones like what used to be Metro, what used to be Cricket. Now we have Mint Mobile, we have Ultra Mobile, Ultimate Mobile, we have AT&T prepaid. So let's dig into that. I want to help you guys as the consumer make a better and more conscious decision when deciding to pick an MVNO. Now, when you're picking an MVNO, the first thing you want to do is, let me explain what an MVNO. It is a mobile virtual network operator, MVNO. I started off with an MVNO when I started off in mobile. My first job was actually with Helio Mobile, and Helio, all of the devices came from SK Telecom because we were majorly backed by them. And those devices actually ran an early version of what ended up becoming Android. They were one of the first devices to actually be able to play encoded video. You were able to have an app store on them, and they were revolutionary to say the least. They were also the first phones to have unlimited. A lot of companies patterned themselves after Helio because they were highly disruptive. They were one of the first companies to pander to the hipster crowd, the younger teenage crowd, give away devices for 99 cents, which was unheard of at that time. Pretty much they disrupted. What T-Mobile did, they essentially took Helio's old playbook and brought it along for the ride. Now, you have companies that are doing it left and right, but what is the difference between all of them? Let's understand one thing. Back then, there was Sprint, there was Verizon, there was AT&T, there was Singular. AT&T ended up buying Singular. They merged. First, they were operating as two separates. Then they merged, kind of like how Sprint and T-Mobile are doing now, but on a kind of completely separate level. Now they're one. You had Cricket and Metro. Now, I'll be honest with you, I'm from the hood. And in the hood and in the suburbs, I lived in the suburbs too. Pretty much, if you had Metro or Cricket, you are considered kind of broke. So, because most people were on their parents' plan, they didn't have their parents' plan, they had a sidekick or they had something like that, you know. And so you had these companies that were taking advantage of that. These young people didn't have much money. So they would come up with these plastic-esque devices with really sweet UIs on them that used unlimited features that younger people used. Keyword, younger people. Because see, younger people are impulse buyers. They're the demographic people want. Immigrants are the people that MVNOs want. Why? In these meetings, like I say, I worked for T-Mobile. I started off in Helio corporate, actually, and I moved to T-Mobile in the store. I went from T-Mobile in the store to training sales employees to corporate at T-Mobile. And then when we purchased Metro PCS, I was asked to go over and do the same kind of sales training that I did for T-Mobile for the Metro PCS stores. But what ended up happening was they wanted me to run the corporate stores. and integrate the T-Mobile way into T-Mobile. But the problem is, you have two different demographics. With T-Mobile, we were postpaid at the time. We had contracts at the time. Metro PCS did not. They were the Wild Wild West. So when you have the Wild Wild West, what's going to happen? You have immigrants up the wazoo who don't speak English, who only know their bill is one amount. Just that one amount. Don't understand anything else. If you try to explain why it's going up, you completely lose them. You have family plans up the wazoo, and you also have, I want to say what they call, I hate it because in the meetings I felt sick to my stomach, the uneducated urban demographic, aka black people with no high school diploma, who impulse buy things. So let's just be frank about it. That was Metro's targeting audience, and I let them know, hey, this is highly, highly prejudicial and disrespectful. And it is the wrong way to go. And this is everything that is wrong with Metro PCS. And it took a while for them to get it, but they eventually were able to integrate the T-Mobile way into Metro. And it became Metro by T-Mobile. Now, some of that stink has gotten brushed off, but it's still a stink on it. But the service is vastly improved. They've moved from essentially an MVNO to essentially just T-Mobile prepaid. Why T-Mobile prepaid still exists, I don't know. It makes zero sense. They're in competition with each other because the prices are similar. But with Metro PCS, you actually get more. You get the Amazon Prime and the Google One. If you get the $60 plan, if you get the $50 plan, you get the Google One, but it's still unlimited. And I think the $40 plan is just regular with no extras. Now, the thing to look out for is AT&T turned around and said, well, we're going to buy Cricket, which was the other broke one. Now, with Cricket, they tried to put a whole bunch of fuzzy ball lint cleaner looking animals in the commercials. I don't know what to call them, but that's what they were. And you put them in there with WWE superstars, and I don't know who they were trying to reach with that. But Cricket, AT&T, you know. Then you have the worst of the worst. Let me tell you, Xfinity Mobile would be the absolute worst MVNO for anyone to go to. Period. Verizon transitioned from 4G LTE and 5G from their old CDMA network. So now they're running GSM. However, their back-end system is still set up like a CDMA carrier, meaning you can swap SIMs, but you can't swap SIMs. Their system will catch you and clip your phone. It sucks. Really, they don't acknowledge their mistakes. Like, T-Mobile will fix it. They'll have a network technician within 72 hours at a tower if it goes down. Verizon, they don't care. I was offered Xfinity Mobile through my internet carrier, which happens to be Comcast because of the monopoly with cable carriers. And having Xfinity Mobile for 9 days was the absolute worst experience I've ever had in life. I was averaging, and I mean average, and this is me being fair, 9 megabytes to 3 megabytes download speed on 5G. I failed consistently every upload test, every upload. None. I got like 0.03 and maybe a 0.07 if my memory serves me correctly. I posted them on my Twitter at Skrilldilly, Skrill_Dilly if you want to go check them out. I talk about them all the time. I even add them and let them know how much they suck because they should know. You know, I know as an MVNO, they have no control over the network, but Verizon does. And they can raise enough stink to get Verizon to get on it. And the problem I have with this is my area is shown on their map as covered in strong 5G. This is completely false. Completely, patently false. There's no way I'm getting 2G speeds in an area that's supposed to be blanketed with 5G, according to Verizon's network map, Verizon prepaid network map, Xfinity Mobile's network map. And to make matters worse, when you use Xfinity Wi-Fi, which I happen to have at home, their network signature is so horrible that it degrades my iPhone 13 Pro Max's Wi-Fi data. Yes, you heard that right. The signal data from their Wi-Fi tower that is running synonymously in the background of my iPhone 13 Pro Max unlocked on Xfinity Mobile interferes with my home Wi-Fi, and my phone becomes unusable. Now, you may say, oh, it's just your area, maybe it's your area. It shouldn't be just my area. And guess what? It's not. I got so curious, I wasted $100, gas is high, and rode around the entire metroplex of Atlanta. We have what's called 285, and 285 is a highway that runs a complete circle around Atlanta. Complete circle. I drove it. I never once got past 3 bars max, occasionally. And even at those 3 bars, I remained at 5G, no ultra wideband at all. I never saw ultra wideband. I stayed in 5G or 4G LTE, but my speeds never improved. After calling and spending roughly, I believe it was, I totaled 10 hours and 36 minutes with reps in the Philippines, I got sick of it. I called, spoke with executive support. I got a lot of credits. I didn't want them because what good are the credits going to do if I can't use the service? I mean, let's be real. So you've got these credits, but what can you do? And so I decided to go ahead and just port my number up. Now, was I going to port it back to T-Mobile? Absolutely not. Magenta Max is ridiculous right now. You're looking at almost $100. It didn't used to be that way. It used to be $75. Then the late fees are increasing. Now, you have Magenta. That's 75. It's not even worth it. So I went, decided, hey, same service, I'll go to Metro. Now, the thing with Metro and Cricket and Mint Mobile and all of these MVNOs, they're not really carriers. What they do is they buy minutes in bulk from these carriers, which is basically saying, hey, can we use some of your tower capacity? And they say, sure. But if anybody goes over 35 gigs a month, we're going to slow them down. Fine. So that's the difference. With T-Mobile, you're, what, I think it's 55 or 65. But rarely do they slow you down. The main problem is when you have a network that slows you down, how fast are they slowing you down? Throttling can be an issue with Metro because, see, there's tiers. T-Mobile, the main T-Mobile that you pay for, even if you go over that 55, you're still first priority on that tower. So that means if someone from Metro PCS hops on that tower and needs to use that, they're going to get bumped off the tower. They're causing to accidentally disconnect. Accidentally. And that person from T-Mobile is going to get priority with data. They're going to get slammed and pushed all the way to the bottom, and their data is going to go super slow. Why? Because someone from T-Mobile needs to use data. They're tier one. Tier two is T-Mobile prepaid and Metro PCS. So those are your tier two. Tier three are your lifeline services like Assurance Wireless. And Sprint right now is actually using tier three. They're doing that purposefully to try to make the service so bad that those people move over to T-Mobile. And it's working, but you got some older people that just don't want to switch. Assurance Wireless is a free service provided by Lifeline, which is a fund from the government that they give these wireless carriers to provide free phones for older people, disabled people who receive SSI, who receive EBT SNAP benefits, things like that. I have one right here. This is what they're giving out. I'm going to cover my name because I put a sticker on this. This is what they give out, bro. Look at this. Shock. What is a shock? Shock. Never heard of it. But you can see it and you can get it. Now, this shock, it's free. I mean, you can't complain with free. It's running a version of Android 11 Go. As you can see, let's look at that. I don't have any screens set up, but you can see that all animation's off. Look at that. Horrible. I mean, the screen rate's horrible. I mean, it's horrible, but don't look to it to be a pixel. It's not gonna be. It's free. Again. So that's what they give you on that kind of MVNO. Now with them, you don't get unlimited. You get 4.5 gigabytes of data. You get unlimited text, which is SMS. And the reason they don't care about unlimited texting is because the heavy lifting on their SMS network has been pretty much killed off by iMessage and by the fact that everyone's using RCS on the newer Android phones. And so they're not really putting a taxing on the network. You're getting 1,000 voice minutes, which most people rarely use, unless you're just sitting on the phone on hold a lot, which I do, because of the companies I have to call. I don't ever call them from my actual number, because I don't even have a number. So what I'll do is put it on Wi-Fi and then use Google Voice and then use that instead of using minutes. Little hint. So, would I suggest getting an MVNO in 2022 going into 2023? Absolutely. But if you're going to get one that's directly from the carrier, not a Mint Mobile, not an Ultimate Mobile, not a Helio Mobile. I mean, they don't exist anymore, but none of the other MVNOs, never. Get one that's actually owned by the carrier because they're going to get the most benefits for you. I would say right now your best value would be Metro PCS, period. There's nothing else that can be said because Cricket right now is crawling. AT&T is so far behind right now. They're moving at 3G speeds on 5G phones. They're more than capable of doing more. Verizon, same thing. Unless you're in a test market where they're testing super fast network speeds, the average person is going to get 2G speeds, 2G speeds on the 5G device, trust me. I've tried every single service. They all suck. Xfinity, retire. Leave, I beg you. Give it up. Stick to home internet. Stick to wireline, keep running Comcast, NBC, make sure I get Law & Order SUV on time. That's all I'm concerned about from you guys. Otherwise, I don't want a phone from you guys. Stop offering it, don't want it. I've had it 9 days, canceled it, ported it out. That is the fastest I've ever left the carrier in my life. I've always maintained the T-Mobile line, even when I had other carriers. So, in saying that, and in conclusion, your best bet would be Metro PCS. And they have the ACP program, which is the Affordable Care Program, which used to be the electronic benefit program. It's something Joe Biden signed to help people, since they're working from home so much, to get $30 off their home internet. You can combine that with Internet Essentials with Comcast, which is $9.99 if you receive any kind of benefits, government benefits of any kind, no matter the age, if your kids do, you do, whatever. No judgment here. You can get free internet, essentially. If you don't want to use your ACP on that, you can use your ACP on your Assurance Mobile phone, which is through T-Mobile again. So you do get great service with them. I will say that. Their customer service is crappy because the entire thing is automated. It's hard to get someone on the phone. And also, when you do, they're from the Philippines. They're very friendly, though. Metro PCS, Philippines, majority of the time, but they're very friendly. Now, Xfinity, Philippines, douches. They're horrible. They hate you when you call in. They don't like you the minute you call. You can say, hi, my name is... I hate you. What do you want? That's how they act. I swear. That's what made me cancel. So, for you guys, This has been 25 minutes of important information that I think you really need to digest and think about before spending your hard-earned money. Buy your phone unlocked. If you have a phone from T-Mobile, pay it off. If you got an 800 buck check coming, income taxes coming, pay your phone off. This is an iPhone 13 Pro Max. This phone is still current. There is no iPhone 14. So, I'm not going to update this phone until maybe iPhone 15 or 16. It's not going to be during this iterative update phase. I'm not going to do that. Because in the end, they're using the same sensors, materials. They might move a notch here. They might add a feature here or there, but isn't life changing? No, it's not, baby. Stick to what you know. Stick to what you do. Metro PCS is the way to go. Bring your own phone is the plan, and it is the best situation for you to be in. I would not suggest anything other than Metro PCS as far as an MVNO. T-Mobile prepaid would be the next step up, and then T-Mobile. And it's not because I'm a T-Mobile employee or anything like that. It just is what it is. And we're going to service, coverage, customer care, and benefit to ratio. Like, you get nothing with each other carriers but hard shafting and bubblegum. That's it. You're paying all this money for what? Nothing. You're getting your service. It's slow. It's hard to talk to people. And you're going to be upset. Where at least with all the T-Mobile subsidiaries, you get to talk to somebody. If they mess up, they will credit you. They're not hard, strong, over. Just main T-Mobile, I would kind of stay away from right now because they're trying to recoup a lot of money they spent on the Sprint merger. So they're adding money on to late fees. They're adding money onto plans, whether it's $5 or $10. The actual device MSRPs are going up. Even though it looks like they're free, they're not. So essentially, it's a contract still. If you guys have any questions, I'll be below answering any questions. No matter when you see this video, if it's a year from now, later on this year, or right now. And let's discuss this in the bottom as far as how you feel with MVNOs, if you use an MVNO, and the reasons why, and do the benefits even matter to you? Some people, the benefits don't matter. It's more about the minutes and the throttle. I mean, me, I've been hung around Wi-Fi a lot, so I don't really care. But I do happen to hit those marks, and I don't get slowed down with T-Mobile. So, this is your boy, Hilo Pasehe, bringing you the news today. And I'll get with you guys later. See you next vid. I appreciate you for stopping by. Please subscribe. Leave. And I appreciate it. You guys have a good one. God bless.